7 décembre 1988. Il est 11h41, en terre d'Arménie. 45 secondes plus tard, 25 000 orphelins.
It was a day of darkness and grief for the residents of the Armenian cities of Spitak and Gyumri. But 3,000 miles away, in France, a man of great sensitivity and compassion heard their desperate call, and he rose without hesitation to the challenge. Charles Aznavour was already an artist of legendary stature when the earthquake struck Armenia, but now he would take up another role, his greatest, the role of selfless humanitarian. Just days after a powerful earthquake rumbled across northern Armenia in December 1988, Aznavour and his longtime producer, Levon Sayan, launched the Aznavour pour l'Arménie Foundation to spark the worldwide relief effort. By the beginning of the following year, Aznavour had enlisted nearly 90 artists in the Pour toi Arménie project, a song that shot to the top of the French singles chart and became a beloved international anthem. Aznavour himself toured the devastated regions, bringing hope to orphan children, the elderly, and families bereft of their loved ones. "The world is with you," his famous song went. "God will heal your bruised land."
Aznavour meant so much to the Armenians living in Armenia and in the diaspora when he started supporting Armenia, reaching out to the needs of the people in Armenia. And indeed, Armenians will always remain grateful to this great artist, great humanitarian, this great man of vision who reached out to support independent Armenia.
When people would say he was a French man, he'd say, "No, no, I'm Armenian." And there was such pride in that. And more he started to talk about his country. And then when things got really bad, he was in a position, he'd done everything else in the world, he'd conquered every media, you know, film, television, the stage, of course, and written great songs for other people. But he started to think more and more and talk about Armenia more and more. And he made a decision to do something. And he did. And I was lucky enough to be a witness to that.
Charles Aznavour was born in Paris to Armenian parents, and his musical soul asserted itself early in his life. It was his magical voice, plaintive and tender, that singled him out in his generation, garnering Aznavour widespread recognition before he turned 30.
She may be the beauty of the beast, maybe the famine of the feast, may turn each day into a heaven or hell.
A lyricist of poetic power, his songs deal with the deeply personal realities of life and touch audiences with their candid explorations of the human condition.
The art of his language, the art of the French that he speaks, is so beautiful. It's like the best poet in the world. And the paintings that he makes of what he's talking about, you feel like you're there. So whether he's singing about, you know, a woman who's in love with a deaf and dumb man, which is a song that he taught me, or he's singing about, you know, a lost love and how old he is, and you understand exactly what he means because you're watching a movie. It's so personal. It's like he's singing just to you.
When I was in Beirut as a student, during moments of sadness, during moments of joy, there were three singers who consoled me. Edith Piaf, Charles Trenet, above all else, Charles Aznavour. He typified for me, symbolized for me, stood for the fact that the unique, in this case Armenian, can participate in universal France, French culture. without dissolving itself.
In a career bridging two centuries, Aznavour has recorded more than 700 songs, acted in more than 60 films, and inspired generations of fellow artists.
When I was 18, I had gone to see Aznavour. And I thought, why am I doing this? I'm going to see some Frenchman sing. It's not in English, and you know, whatever. And I sat there, and the minute he walked on the stage, I stopped breathing. And it was like a magnet pulling me in. I just thought, I've never seen anything like this. He told me stories. He carried me with him all over the place. It was just extraordinary. So now I start to do my nightclub act. I finished my Broadway show. And, you know, I didn't meet him or anything. And I put in one of his songs, There Is a Time, or Le Temps. And I was playing at the Coconut Grove in Hollywood. And I was singing his song. And I looked out. And there he was sitting there. And I honestly thought I would die, thinking, oh my God, he's sitting there. I want to perform like he does. I want to be a storyteller. I don't want to be a singer. I want to be a storyteller, an actress who sings songs and tells about how different people live and think and their passions. So he came backstage to see me, and really I was just in awe. And I asked him, I said, may I please be your student? Will you teach me? Will you be my mentor? And he said, yes. And I studied, and he would teach me, and he'd say, it needs this here, it needs that here. Yes, it's fine. You're trying too hard. And I really was a good student, and I learned. But I never did a show without showing it to him first. Ever. The sound of your name can bring chimes of desire that flares like a flame as it climbs ever higher, that burns in my senses and turns them to fire. The sound of your name. As Aznavour's friendship with Liza Minnelli blossomed, the two went on to fruitful collaborations on a multitude of projects. When I went to Paris for the first time and I opened at the Olympia, he came out on stage and he was going to introduce me, and I'm waiting for something nice, and he said, ladies and gentlemen, Liza Minnelli. And he jumped off the stage and sat down. I thought, okay. And I sang, there was a song about my name called Liza with a Z. And he said, it's very important that you sing this in French. I said, Charles, I can barely sing in English. And he said, no, I'll teach it to you. And I learned it with the tape recording he gave me. It went, c'est l'isavec, c'est pas l'isavec, est-ce car l'isavec, est-ce fais, pas, donc c'est au lieu de S, là au lieu de li, dites comment je dis, donc Liza.
Wait, I'll do it again. Say, Liza Vec said, Polisa Vec S, Kalisa Vec S, space, puzz, don't settle you the S, lie on you the Lee, did mange dit, don't Liza.
And I sang that, and it was like I made friends with the audience instantly, and that was all I wanted to do.
Charles Aznavour's Armenian heritage has always been an integral part of his inner vision and sense of self. It has led him to take up outspoken positions on issues important to the Armenian people.
Charles Aznavour is, by any definition of the term, a world artist. People know him and love him. And as such, there's a lot of power in that, and there's a lot of responsibility. And he has used that responsibility to bring focus on the issues of the Armenian genocide.
Aznavour has been and continues to remain tireless advocate for the recognition of Armenian genocide, and his boundless humanitarian service to Armenia is truly commendable. His talent and deeds have built a bridge of mutual trust, not only between his two homelands, France and Armenia, but among other countries as well.
In 1975, on the 60th anniversary of the Armenian Genocide, Aznavour penned, Ils sont tombés, they fell, in loving tribute to his martyred countrymen of
1915. Comme des hommes ivres, mutilés, massacrés, les yeux ouverts d'effroi, ils sont...
He continued his work for genocide recognition in his roles as Armenia's ambassador to Switzerland and as Armenia's permanent representative to the United Nations office in Geneva. In film, too, Aznavour took up the subject, starring as Edward Saroyan in Atom Egoyan's searing depiction of the genocide and its aftermath, Ararat.
Working with Charles was just such a joy because his eyes tell the whole story. He has this ability to convey all kinds of information with just the tiniest glance, the most minimal amount of movement. This is what makes him one of the real greats.
I have always been very close to the Armenian people, Aznavour told Time magazine in 1998, when he was voted by readers as the entertainer of the century. When I say close, he went on, I mean in my heart and in my mind. After the earthquake, the day after, I thought I owed something to the memory of my family, to my parents, so I committed myself very strongly to try to help the people there.
When he put all of his passion and his time and his stubbornness into helping Armenia, it was spectacular.
In the early 1990s, Aznavour pour l'Arménie began providing 24-hour care to elderly citizens of Vanadzor, Armenia's third largest city. The project, known as the Vanadzor Old Age Home, grew in the ensuing decade. Today, it is managed by the Fund for Armenian Relief with support from the Kevork and Sirvart Karamanuk Foundation.
It's a wonderful place. We have more than 60 men and women there in a terrific, healthy atmosphere. They interact with each other. They play games, chess, backgammon. They fish in a nearby artificial lake we have built for them. They have gardens. It's a sunny place. It's a happy place. It's a serene place.
Charles Aznavour continues his involvement with independent Armenia through his work as a diplomat. For him, as for millions of Armenians worldwide, the existence of an independent Armenia is a centuries-old dream come true, which the present generation is privileged, even blessed, to witness.
The Armenian history has been full of defeats, as well as perseverance, genocide, and then we had Bolshevik Revolution, World War II, hundreds of thousands of Armenians died. Stalin's rule, many of them were sent to Siberia. So this is the first time in centuries that we have relatively peaceful existence protected by international law. So 20 years may not be much for many nations, but for us is a respite.
We are grateful to God for giving us the opportunity to celebrate 20th anniversary of Armenia's independence. And also I am very happy that on this special year, we are honoring Charles Aznavour, who is not only a great artist, a great humanitarian, but also an exemplary Armenian.
It is a rare thing indeed to say that an individual human soul has had a beneficial impact on the entire world. In the case of Charles Aznavour, it is an assertion that can be made with confidence and gratitude.
toi et moi, deux cœurs qui se confondent au seuil de l'infini, loin du reste du monde, à le temps et soumis à bord d'une ligne.
When he gives himself to something, it is all the way, it is total, and it's original, and you can count on it, and you can count on him. And I saw that happen when he made the decision to do something for his country. He cares. I guess that's all I'm trying to say. He cares about everything, and he is the love of my life.
Aznavour's unwavering commitment to the Armenian people continues to this day. And on the eve of the 20th anniversary of Armenia's independence, he remains to the Armenian people a testament to a nation's faith, courage, sacrifice, and determination in the face of seemingly insurmountable odds. Amen.